warm welcome to one and all. It's that time of the year. We're here together to sing and dance and enjoy the evening with our children. Even as we gathered here for the 13th annual concert of Garudiya International Center for Learning, some of our students from the primary grades are heading towards Kolhapur to appear for the national levels of the Mars International Spelling Bee. We've been doing something right somewhere. As per tradition, Garudiya has always emphasized on overall development of every child. Arts, sports, music, and academics form an integral part of the Garudiya education legacy. We couldn't do it bigger, but we've definitely tried to make it better. I hope you all enjoy the evening as much as we have enjoyed putting it together. May I now request the head of school, Ms. Monica Koradia, to address the gathering.
Good evening, everyone. Before we begin with the concert, I had a very nice announcement to make. Last year from the IGCSE batch, we had a country topper. And this year from the March 2017 IGCSE batch from GICL, we have a world topper in Cambridge Mathematics, and which is Ananya Bhatt, who is currently pursuing IBDP with GICLM. A great moment of pride for us. I would like to felicitate the teacher in charge who was responsible for her teaching of math, Ms. Rumana Chatterjee. May I please have her on the stage?
Oh, India, a high-spirited postulant, a nun in training, who becomes a governess for the 7 children of a widowed naval captain. Her kindness and sense of play captures the heart of the children and eventually their grieving father. It is 1938 in Karlsburg, Austria, a fictionalized town in Central Europe. Karlsburg is the home of Nornberg Abbey, where we find the nuns who live there singing prayers as they go about their daily activities. Their songs quickly turn into questions about the location of a young postulant named Maria. This isn't the first time Maria has done this. The nuns wonder if Maria truly belongs in the community because she has a hard time following the rules.
Reverend Mother, sisters, we simply cannot find Maria.
She is missing again.
Perhaps we should tie a cowbell around her neck.
Now, Sister Bear, we simply cannot find her.
Have you tried the barn? You know how much she adores the animals.
We've looked everywhere, in all the usual places.
Sister, considering it's Maria, I suggest you look in unusual places.
I hope this new infraction ends whatever doubts you may still have about Maria's future here at the Abbey.
I always try to keep faith in my doubts.
After all, the wool of a black sheep is just as warm.
We are not talking about sheep.
We are talking about candidates for the novitiate.
I see your point. Of all the candidates, Maria is the least.
Children, please, let us all take a deep breath. Now, what do we really think of our child, Maria?
Well, she's a wonderful girl.
Some of the time.
It's very easy to like Maria, except when it's difficult.
Sisters?
Oh, we love her dearly, but she does seem to get into trouble a lot.
That's exactly what I say.
Yeah.
not speak with Maria?
Yes, Reverend Mother.
Oh, Reverend Mother, I'm so sorry. I just couldn't help myself. The hills were calling and everything was so green and fragrant and I just couldn't stop singing.
Only in the Abbey do we have rules about postulant singing.
But I can't seem to stop singing wherever I am. What's worse, I can't seem to stop saying things. Things I'm thinking or feeling.
Some might call that honesty.
Oh, but it's terrible, Reverend Mother.
Maria, it seems that you'll be leaving us for a while.
Oh, Reverend Mother, please don't send me away. This is where I belong. It's my home, my family, it's my life. If it's God's will.
There's a family near Salzburg that needs a governess until September for 7 children.
7 children?
Do you like children, Maria?
Why, yes. But 7?
Then I'll tell Captain Fontrap to expect you tomorrow.
A captain?
A retired officer of the Imperial Navy. His wife died and he's alone with the children. I understand he's had a difficult time keeping a governess there.
Why difficult, Reverend Mother?
The Lord will show you in his own good time.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
I'm sure you'll make us proud.
I promise to.
With 7 children.
What's so fearsome about that?
Oh, I must stop these doubts, all these worries. If I don't, I just know I'll turn back. I must dream of the things I am seeking. I am seeking the courage I lack. The courage to serve them with reliance. Face my mistakes without defiance. Show them I'm worthy, and while I show them, I'll show me. So let them bring on all their problems. I'll do better than my best. I have confidence they'll put me to the test, but I'll make them see I have confidence in me. Somehow I will impress them. I will be firm but kind, and all those children, heaven bless them, they will look up to me and mind me with each step. I am more certain everything will turn out fine. I have confidence the world can all be mine. They'll have to agree I have confidence in me.
That?
I'm Maria, the new governess.
I'm Fräulein Schmidt, the secretary.
I'm Fräulein Franz, the housekeeper.
I'm Fräulein Helga, the maid.
Oh my, how do you do?
Please wait here with Fräulein Schmidt.
Let's see how long this one lasts.
Thank you, Fräulein Schmidt. You're excused.
Of course, Captain.
Good afternoon, Fräulein Maria. Good afternoon, Fräulein Maria.
Good afternoon, Captain.
Why do you stare at me like that?
Because you don't look at all like a sea captain, sir.
Well, you don't look at all like a governess. Turn around. I don't like that dress. You'll have to change.
I didn't have any other dress. When we enter the Abbey, we give off all our worldly possessions to the poor.
What about this dress?
They didn't want this one. I would have made another dress. It's just that there wasn't enough time. I can make my own clothes.
I'll see that I get you some material. I don't know what the Reverend Mother told you, but I trust you will be an improvement on the last governess. She stayed only 2 hours. Children, this is your new governess, Fräulein Maria, give your name at your signal. Fräulein, listen carefully. Learn their signals so you can call them.
Liesel.
Friedrich.
Luisa.
Kurt.
Brigitta.
Marta.
That's Gretel. Now, when I want you, this is what you will hear.
Oh no, sir. I'm sorry, sir. I could never answer to a whistle. Whistles are for animals, not for children, and definitely not for me.
Fräulein, were you this much trouble at the Abbey?
Oh, much more, sir. I am sorry, sir. I don't know your signal.
You may call me Captain.
At ease. Now that there's just us, would you please tell me all your names again and how old you are?
I'm Liesel. I'm 16 years old and I don't need a governess.
I'm glad you told me, Liesel. We'll just be good friends.
I'm Friedrich. I'm 14 years old and I'm impossible.
Really? Who told you that, Friedrich?
Fräulein Josephine, 4 governesses ago.
I'm Brigitta.
You didn't tell me how old you were. Luisa?
I'm Brigitta. She's Luisa. She's 12 years old and I'm 10. And that's the ugliest dress I've ever seen.
Brigitta, you shouldn't say that.
Why not? Don't you think so?
Why, yes, but Fräulein Anna's was the ugliest. I'm Kurt and I'm incorrigible.
Congratulations.
But what's incorrigible?
I think it means you want to be treated like a boy.
I'm Marta. I'll be 8 on Tuesday. I'd like a pink parasol.
Pink's my favorite color too. Yes, you're Gretel. And you're 5 years old. My, you're practically a lady. I have to tell you all a secret. I've never been a governess.
You don't know anything about being a governess?
Nothing. I need lots of advice.
The best way to start is to tell father to mind his own business.
And always be late to dinner.
And make sure you slurp your soup real loud like this.
During dessert, always blow your nose.
Don't you believe a word they say, Fräulein Maria?
Why not?
Because I like you.
I like you too, Maria.
Children,
children. Outside for your walk. Father's orders.
Hurry up.
Yes, Fräulein Franz.
Poor dears.
Now, children. We are breathing deeply. March. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I'll show you to your room. Follow me.
You know what? You are very lucky. The last governess received a snake. Ah, Rolf, good evening.
Good evening, Fräulein Franz.
Are there any developments?
Perhaps. Is the captain home?
Yes, he's about to retire for the night.
Please give him this telegram at once.
Certainly.
Liesel.
Rolf.
Well, hello. I came by to deliver a telegram.
Aren't you supposed to be in bed by now?
Well, yes, but don't tell. I've missed you. Have you missed me?
Why, yes. I even thought of sending you a telegram so I could deliver it to you.
Oh, Rolf. Oh, that's a lovely thought. Why don't you, right now? I'll start it for you. Dear Liesel,
I'd like to be able to tell you how I feel about you. Stop. Unfortunately, this wire is already too expensive. Stop. Sincerely, Rolf.
Sincerely?
Cordially.
Cordially?
Affectionately.
If only we didn't have to wait for someone to send Father a telegram. How do I know when I'll see you again?
I could come by with a telegram from Colonel Schneider. He's here from Berlin. I've said too much. I worry about your father.
You don't have to worry about him. He's a big naval hero. He was even decorated by the Emperor.
Well then, I worry about his daughter. Or so... Well, you're a baby.
You are hearing things again.
Lizzie!
What on heaven's earth are you doing out there? There's a storm coming. You could catch a cold.
I told you, I knew I wasn't crazy.
Oh, I wouldn't go that far.
I have a good mind to tell your father. What were you doing out there?
Well, I was...
She was fetching me some flowers. No luck, Liesel?
No.
Well then, I'll just have to sleep with that musty smell in the room.
There's nothing wrong with the smell in your room.
Well now, get in there, child, before you catch a cold. There's a storm coming.
And I'll be up in a bit with some mothballs.
Mothballs? Now that's showing your age.
You're not going to tell Father, are you? If we hurry, we can get you out of that dress and into your night clothes before he notices. Come.
I don't smell anything, do you?
Nothing at all.
Now, who's crazy smelling things, huh?
I open the windows.
Well... How do you like your room? There'll be new drapes in the morning.
New drapes? But these are fine.
The captain has ordered them.
Good night now. The captain is going away to visit the Baroness. I think he'll be married by the end of the summer.
That's wonderful. The children will have a new mother.
Yes,
I guess.
I wanted to say good night and thank you.
That's not necessary.
Gretel, are you scared?
Where are the others?
They are not scared. They are asleep.
Oh, really? Look. Well, then everyone come up here on the bed.
Really?
Well, just this once. Now we'll just have to wait for the boys.
Boys are brave. You won't see them.
You're not scared, are you?
Not at all. We just wanted to make sure you weren't scared. It was Kurt's idea.
What?
Why does the thunder get so mean? It makes me want to cry. Me too.
When I'm scared, I just try to think of nice things.
What kind of things?
Well, let's see.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on pigeons.
What's going on here? I told you strict bedtimes. Do you or do you not have difficulty following instructions?
Only during thunderstorms, sir. Come along, children. You heard your father. Off to bed.
Earlier I told you I didn't need a governess. Well, maybe I do.
Fräulein, you have managed to remember that I'm going out of town for 2 months. First thing in the morning.
Yes, sir. I was wondering if I could get some extra material to make play clothes for the children.
I will not have my children traipsing around town in rags.
But they're children.
And I am their father. That'll be all. Good night.
The drapes.
It has been 2 months since Maria has left the abbey.
I can't believe she's lasted that long. It's truly a miracle.
I agree. No, wait. I agree.
And seven children? I don't even have seven friends.
Oh, Sister Catherine, you have many sisters who are also your friends.
I, for one, miss Maria, and I'm not ashamed to say it.
I miss Maria.
What seems to be the fuss? Move along now. Go ahead.
Yes, Reverend Mother.
While the captain is away in Vienna, Maria makes play clothes for the children and takes them around Salzburg and the surrounding mountains. And she teaches them how to sing. Through music, she brings joy and healing to the Von Trapp household. Because of her patient and loving nature, the children eventually warm up to Maria.
Oh, oh, oh. fa-so and so on are the tools we use to build a song. Once you have these notes in your head, you can sing a million different tunes by mixing them up like this.
Do, la, fa, mi, do, re.
Can you do that?
So, do, la, fa, mi, do, re. So, do, la, ti, do, re, do. So, do, la, ti, do, re, do.
Now put it all together.
Enjoyed themselves with Maria. Back at the mansion, the captain has arrived with Baroness Schrader and a friend Max.
I can't wait to see the new lady friend.
I heard she was a baroness.
What's a baroness?
And that's why you're still a maid.
Just asking.
And it's a great question. It's like a princess.
Oh, I hope she's nice.
Me too, like an angel.
I'd like to tell you all something. I'll have my tea at exactly 2 o'clock. No cream, no sugar. Please don't be late with my tea, as I will have to inform the captain.
Oh, she's an angel, all right.
Excuse me, did you say something?
Shh, move along. Welcome, ma'am. Dinner at 8?
Oh, I'm watching my figure. No dinner for me, just a light salad.
Well, you don't need to watch your figure. You're simply lovely.
Well, thank you.
But of course, a most delicious salad will be served just for you.
Mm.
Fräulein? Fräulein Franz, did you tell Max we're having tea out on the terrace?
Yes, sir. Herr Max is still on the phone.
Still no sign of the children?
No, sir. I'll keep looking.
And the mountains?
A magnificent gale.
Yes. They're not like any other mountains. They're friendly.
I'm beginning to understand you here better now that you're at home. How can you be away from such a beautiful place for so long?
Maybe I was just waiting for a reason to come back here to stay.
I like it here very much.
Where is Max? Do you really like it here?
I'm dreadfully sorry I took so long.
Any luck?
How would you like this for the Karlsenburg Festival? The finest choral group in all of Austria. The greatest soprano in all of London.
I would love to hear that.
So would I. Nevertheless, my motto is, never start out looking for talent, you wind up getting. That's why I've been telephoning Paris, Rome, London.
On Gail's phone?
Of course. How else could I afford it? What do you think I'm up here for?
I hoped it was because you liked me.
Of course I like you. I like rich people. I like the way they live. I like the way I live when I'm with them.
Oh, Max, you're outrageous.
Another name I haven't heard before.
Show me around the town, Gail. I'd like to meet all your friends. Well, I know. Let's have a party for me.
That's a marvelous idea.
I don't understand where the children are. If you'll excuse me, I'm going to see where they are.
So, do you think the captain will marry you?
Yes, he hasn't asked yet. But I think there's something in his way.
I know what it is. It's money.
Money? Well, how can love survive without a little money?
Not a sign of them anywhere.
Captain, I found this fellow throwing rocks at Liesel's window.
Who are you?
Oh, Captain, I didn't see. I mean, I don't know. Hi.
Why are you here, boy?
I have a telegram for Captain Von Trapp.
All right, you've delivered your telegram. Now get out.
Yes, sir.
Oh, Gail, he's only a boy.
And I'm just an Austrian. Our world is disappearing before our eyes.
What's going to happen is going to happen. Just don't let it happen to you.
Oh, Captain, you're home.
Father, you're home.
Welcome home, Captain. And you must be Baroness Schrader.
This is Baroness Schrader. And these are my children.
How do you do?
Children, get out of those ridiculous clothes and change for the Baroness immediately. Hurry up.
Excuse us.
I will see if there is any more strudel.
Maria, where did you get these abominations? Out of a nightmare?
No, I made them out of the drapes in my room.
Do you mean to tell me my children have been all around Salzburg wearing those clothes?
Yes, they've become very popular. Everyone smiles at them.
I don't wonder.
They say, oh look, there go the Von Trapp children.
They have uniforms.
Children cannot do things they're supposed to do if they have to worry about their precious clothes.
I don't care to hear anything further from you about my children.
I am not finished yet, Captain.
Oh yes, you are, Captain. Fräulein? Now you will pack your bags at once.
Of course, Captain.
Excuse me, Captain. The children have prepared a song as a gift for the Baroness. Let them perform before they change.
Tum enter kar rahe ho na?
Not now, ma'am. Directly in the party scene.
The hills are alive with
I've behaved badly. You were right. I don't know the children.
There's still time.
I want you to stay. I ask you to stay.
If I could be of any help.
You've already done more than you know.
Thank you, children, for such a wonderful gift.
This calls for a celebration. I found my new group.
Very funny.
Gail, do you sing?
I used to, a long time ago.
Will you sing for me, Gail? Please, for me?
Edelweiss, every morning you greet me, small and white, clean and bright, you look happy to meet me. Blossom of snow, may you bloom and grow, bloom and grow forever. Edelweiss, bless my homeland forever. Right, you look happy to meet me. Blossom of snow, may you bloom and grow, bloom and grow forever. Edelweiss, Edelweiss, my homeland forever.
Oh, that was wonderful, Gail.
Let's get started. Have you got all your puppets ready?
Yes, we have.
Then what are we waiting for? Off you go.
Just can't hear the doctor's own.
Very good.
Wonderful.
Anytime you say the word, Gail, you can be part of my new act, the Fontrath Family Singers.
Max, my children do not sing in public.
Okay, but you can't blame me for trying. I think we should have a wonderful gala. What do you say, Gail?
Yes, let's really fill this house with music. You must have a grand and glorious party for me.
A party? Yes, Father. Please let's have a party.
All right. But it'll take a lot of planning.
Oh, goody.
But for now, come on. It's bedtime. So say good night.
Good night, Father. Baroness. Our first party ever.
No, a lady curtsies. That's right. You must do that to all the guests now.
All guests? Won't my knees get tired?
That's the price of being a lady.
Everyone looks so beautiful. I guess we look beautiful too.
I think they look ugly.
You just say that because you're scared.
Silly, only grown-up men are scared of women.
We've never had a party in the house before. This is so exciting.
Oh yes, there used to be a lot of parties here.
Oh yes, I remember. Friedrich and I used to sneak out and watch everyone from the top of the stairs.
I remember the music. Once, Father brought a gypsy orchestra all the way from Budapest.
Oh yes, they wore red coats and they used to dance like this.
Who are you dancing with? With me. Come, Lisa, let's dance.
Yuck.
Why didn't your children tell me you could dance?
We were afraid you would make us dance together, the Fontrath family dancers.
May I have this dance, young man?
Since it's you, Fräulein Maria.
I seem to have forgotten the rest.
Ahem. There you are, darling.
Good evening, Baroness. Come along, children. Bedtime now.
I really must speak to the cook about the dessert. It's entirely too delicious for my figure.
I'm sorry, Baroness.
Don't say another word. You see, there are other things I've been thinking of while planning this party over the past few weeks. I've seen the way you look at Maria. I know you've grown fond of her. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to go back inside and pack my little things and go back to Vienna where I belong. Somewhere out there is a young lady who I think will never be a nun.
Captain, another telegram has arrived.
I really think the children should be in my festival. They are so very talented. Is everything okay?
They've offered me a commission in their navy. I've been requested to report by tomorrow morning.
I knew this day would come, but so soon?
I have to find Maria.
Children, the captain and I have decided to leave Austria.
Why are you holding hands?
Father,
did you marry Maria?
Not yet.
Our new mother.
Well, not yet. But we have to hurry and be really quiet. Something like that.
I wish you could be singing in my festival.
Perhaps another time.
To stop them, Captain.
That's okay, Fräulein Schmidt.
Going somewhere, Captain?
We were just going for a walk.
How convenient. You're supposed to report for duty for the German Navy tomorrow.
Rolf, what are you doing?
Was I? I don't recall receiving a telegram about that.
You received several. In fact, you never answered the last one from the Admiral of the Navy. I've come here to take you directly there myself.
Well, that's impossible, gentlemen.
Why is that?
The family phone trap is singing in the Salzburg Festival tonight. It's all arranged.
Yes. I only hope we're not too late. We really should hurry.
Once again, how convenient. Let's go, Herr Zeller. The general is waiting.
Stop. A slight delay in my orders will not be serious. Therefore, you will sing. You will all sing. But that is only because I want it to be. I want the people of Salzburg to see that nothing has changed. And after you have finished singing, Captain, you will be taken directly to Bremerhaven.
Have a wonderful performance by the Augustus Choir.
Yeah.
Thank you. May I now present the family phone trap.
My fellow Austrians, I may not see you all again, perhaps for a very long time. I would like to sing for you now, a love song. I know you share this love. I pray that you'll never let it die.
The conclusion of the show, but we don't know yet what that conclusion will be. And while the judges arrive at their decision, I have been given permission to offer you an encore. This will be the last opportunity the Fontraps will have of singing together for a long, long time. Even now, officials are waiting in this auditorium to escort Captain Fontrap to his new command in the naval forces of the Third Reich. So, ladies and gentlemen, the family Fontrap again to bid you farewell.
There's a sad sort of clanging from the clock in the hall and the bells in the steeple too. And up in the nursery and up the little bird is popping out to say
Bella.
ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our show. We now have the winners of the show. In second place, the Augustus Choir Group. And for the first prize, the highest honor in all of Austria, goes to the Family Phone Trap. The Phone Trap family singers. The Family Phone Trap.
Herr Zeller, they're gone.
And the Family Phone Trap has left Salzburg forever. With the help of the nuns from the abbey, they escape the Nazi soldiers. They climb every mountain and flee to Switzerland and then onwards to America to safety and freedom.
There's a sad sort of clanging from the clock in the hall and the bells in the steeple too. And up in the nursery an absurd little bird is calling out to say cuckoo,
cuckoo, cuckoo.
Regretfully cuckoo, they kill us, but firmly cuckoo, they compel us to say goodbye.
Cuckoo,
cuckoo, regretfully they tell us, but
concert today. It is time to thank each and every person who was responsible in the making of this concert. Firstly, I would like to thank our special invitees, special guests, who took our time out to attend this concert. Thank you so much, Film Ma'am, Lalita Ma'am, Meeta Ma'am, Mr. Ian. Thank you so much. And we have been very fortunate enough to be backed by a team of motivated and dedicated teachers who have worked tirelessly for this event. May I have Ms. Vidya Rao? Ms. Vidya Rao, who's in charge for the script and the direction of this concert. Put your hands together for Ms. Vidya Rao. Ms. Regina D'Souza and Mr. Ralph D'Souza for the music and training of our choir team. Mr. Vicky Thakur, dance company, for the choreography. Ms. Shivani, Ms. Geeta, Ms. Uma, and Ms. Akshita, who are the in charge for the main cast costumes. Ms. Palak for lights, Ms. Rosie for music, Ms. Priya Singh, Ms. Sandhya Pal, Ms. Poonam, Ms. Preeti, Ms. Riya, Ms. Zarna, Ms. Varnima, and Ms. Anusha for the props. Mr. Ranjit and Mr. Roshan for the backstage coordination of sets. All the class teachers who are in charge for their dances. Classic Dresswala for the costumes. And I must mention our deep sense of appreciation for all our non-teaching staff for their involvement and willingness to take on the completion of tasks beyond their comfort zones. I would like to thank Ms. Seema for the admin department, who has been coordinating various things for this event. A sincere thanks to the stage setters, the photographers, sound and light engineers, and the management of Fine Arts Auditorium, who added color and festivity to this event. Our director, Mr. Nishant Garodia, who has guided us throughout this event. And finally, we thank our students at GICL who have been practicing for this entire month tirelessly. A big round of applause for our students. And for the lovely audience, all the parents out here, thank you so much. Thank you. May I request all of you please stand up for the school song followed by the national anthem.
If you believe and if you try, yes, you can touch the sky. All you do is believe in yourself. You can do it if you try. So feel the power that's there within you, deep inside your heart. Don't be afraid, 'cause we have each other, standing strong and never apart. Reach for your dreams. Today is a brand new day. That's ahead, so full of adventure. So what are you waiting for? So feel the power is there within you, deep inside your heart. Don't be afraid, 'cause we have each other, standing strong and never apart. Reach for your dreams. Today is a brand new day. We are the future, shining through along the way.
Reach for your dreams. We are the heroes, we are the Thank you.